please Bill Drummond and Jim Pott. Bill Drummond and Jim Pott. You see, that film actually runs for the best part of an hour, and we're keeping it up on that screen there, rolling as we talk. So why, Bill? Why?
There was a lot of reasons why, and there's still a lot. We're still discovering reasons every day.
You see, those people are not... The people in our audience are not really tuned in. They think I'm kidding. They think I'm joking. They think that it's funny money or monopoly money or whatever.
That's serious.
It's actual money. Yeah. And is there a philosophy behind this? Is this sort of a denial of the material world or something?
No. Some days it is that, but it's not really that. You know, we could have done with the money. We wanted the money. But we wanted to burn it more.
But if you burned a million, then you must have made three or four in your music career up to
then. No, that was the only million we'd got. And when we've both got, you know, reasonable houses, and we both don't have to, neither of us on the dole.
Yeah, and your wives and families.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
How many kids have you, Bill?
I've got four kids.
And Jim?
I've got two.
Two. Mm-hmm. And what did you feel as you saw it burning?
Numb. I was on autopilot. You had to be on autopilot to do something like that. If you're thinking about it, if you're thinking about every 50 quid or bundles, because we were having to chuck bundles on, just because it was taking a long time to do, and we wanted to get back to the hotel and get some sleep.
What did your wives feel about it then?
It has caused problems.
I would think it has caused problems.
From time to time.
I would think it has. And do you never foresee the day when, God forbid, your children may need a serious operation?
Oh, yeah. We thought about that. We know about all that.
That's part of it. Yeah. I mean, right from the beginning, before we ever did it, we knew that maybe 15 years down the line, one of my children, or one of Jimmy's children, you know, they've got something wrong with them. There's only one doctor in California, and it's going to cost X hundred thousand. Right. And that's part of the thing you live with. And that's part of...
You could easily spend that money in a couple of years anyway, and then it's the same thing. The money's going to get spent one way or the other.
But what are you looking for now? Why are you showing this film, and it's still running there, it is on the screen, why are you showing this film around in schools and building sites and so on? Is it to get people's reaction?
No, it's not to get people's reaction. I think a lot of people can get something out of it.
What?
Well, like, you look at a painting, you get something back from it, don't you? People look at this film...
Looking at it right now, it could be just a furnace burning. Mm-hmm. It could be logs or coal or whatever, anything at all. So I don't know how you get anything from it. Yes. I think what you're generating amongst people is just sheer resentment, you know, anger.
Well, we're not out for that. There'd be no point, either.
It generates a lot of things in people's heads, and some parts of it is anger.
Yes.
Some parts of it is jealousy. Some parts of it is... They don't understand it because it's pulling in a lot of different directions at once.
You've been asked it a million times, I know. What about all the people who want hip replacement operations and old people and young people and handicapped people and kidney cancer?
Obviously, we thought about that, and we're not a charitable organisation. We thought that there's plenty of people who want to give money to charity. We wanted to do something that we found more interesting with the money. More interesting than giving it away to charity.
I think of all the people who are in need of help in this country and in your own country, millions of them, and they're so badly off and so on. And a great number of people, including myself, must be looking at you both and saying, "What kind of weird people are you?"
Yeah, hang on. There's no.
I'm not being unfriendly.
I know that.
Yeah.
People, if we'd gone and spent the money on swimming pools and Rolls Royces, I don't think people would be upset.
No.
It's because we've burnt it.
Yes.
They're upset. And I know this is a kind of a corny thing to say and it doesn't really stand up, but seeing as you're talking about the kind of charity angle or the, you could buy stuff, us burning that money doesn't mean there's any less loaves of bread in the world, any less apples, any less anything. The only thing that's less... It's a pile of paper.
No, there could have been a little more. It's not less, but there could have been a little more.
More what? Another
more loaf? Bread, more apples, whatever.
No, we didn't burn any loaves of bread.
No, but
we didn't burn any apples.
But you could have bought loaves of bread.
No, but those loaves of bread would still have existed. Do you know what I mean? There's actually nothing. There's nothing less in the world other than a pile of paper.
I used to talk to my dad like that when I was 16.
Well, I'm still talking to my dad like that, and I'm 42.
can gather from that is it's just it's grown up men acting like little boys, and it's a publicity exercise, and that all you wanted was some publicity, just like Madonna or whoever else.
But you see, I would understand that if they did something with the publicity, but they're not doing anything with the publicity. They've given up the music business. That's it. You just sort of.
Okay, what are we selling?
Well, why are you here then? The reasonable question. Why are you here on the Late Late Show?
We were invited.
Yeah, well, you were invited, of course. Yeah, because we wanted to have a look at you. But I mean, what's the purpose, Jim?
Well, if you're an artist and you make a work of art,
yes,
you for some reason you want to share it with people.
Yeah,
I don't know why.
Okay, let's leave it there. Sorry, I'll just take another phone call. Line one. Hello, line one. Line one?
Hello, yes.
Evening, yes.
Good evening. My reaction to that is happiness and contentment is in your head, not in your pocket.
Have you happiness and contentment?
It's not in my head.
Not in your head. You're not happy and content.
No.
You're not?
No.
And the £1 million burning it didn't improve that situation?
No, we weren't doing it to make ourselves happy. But, I mean, we're not driven trying to make ourselves happy.
What's your reaction, Joe?
Mine?
Yeah.
I want to know if it was like a chemically induced decision to do it.
No, we were totally straight.
Well, I think a couple of sandwiches short of a picnic, personally. Sorry, people are different, you know, I mean, like... Everybody, we're in a rock and roll band, and there's other people that would even argue the fact that Def Leppard are a true rock and roll band, that we've never thrown tellies out of windows and stuff like that. But to dispose of £1 million, if I was going to do it, I would think I would rather set up some kind of recording studio for the unemployed kids or something.
Something.
It doesn't have to go to Bosnia. It doesn't have to go to. I would, you know. I think you can make an artistic statement without, like, you know, that you can help people rather than just, like, waste it. You know?
I think we have helped people. We have helped people by burning that money.
How?
It brings something into people's heads, and it helps them.
Yeah, but it brings it into their heads while we're talking about it on telly. They won't be thinking about it tomorrow.
Well, yes, fair enough.
But there'll be people still starving tomorrow. There should be kids who can't make a record.
That's beside the point.
No, it's not.
It is.
Yeah.
Did you and Rick know the music of Bill and Jim?
Some of it.
Yeah. And you reckon they could go back into the music business any time?
Well, of course they could. They've obviously got the talent to do it. There's no time limit on anyway. It's not Logan's Run.
Mm.
You know? I mean, everybody thinks we're all supposed to die at the age of 32.
You are. That's a problem.
You tell me.
You're a proper rock and roll star. You need to die for drug overdose.
No, there's no such thing as proper rock and roll. Rock and roll is music, not the lifestyle. That's bull.
I don't know. I really agree with that.
You know?
Sorry, who's the gentleman with glasses up there, blue shirt? Yeah, hi.
Yeah, I think it's disgusting that two people should be allowed to do such a thing with so much poor. In this country and in the foreign countries, it's an absolute disgrace.
Their argument is it's their money. They can do what they like with it.
Yes, I can see that, but surely they have a conscience too.
Jim, you're smiling all the way through this. You're kind of amused by the whole thing. What's your reaction to what
you're
saying?
Well, I mean, don't forget that we've been touring around for the last 2 months and we've heard a lot of different arguments. And people seem to get stuck on the kind of, you know, the charity thing, the why didn't you get it, give it to me, and it gets more interesting if people can move on and see it as something else.